Маємо приємність вітати сьогодні на програмі відомого коментатора канадського радіо, гумориста Теда Волошина, який розповість про його новий подкастинг-проєкт та безпосередні особисті поради відносно недуги COVID, яку пережив, перебуваючи в шпиталі 9 днів.
Вітаємо вас, дорогі глядачі, на українській телемережі «Контакт». Як ви щойно чули, Марта заповідала, маємо цікавого гостя сьогодні. Pana Ted Vološina. Mr. Vološin, welcome to our show. Pane Teodosi, дуже приємно вас знову бачити.
Щиро дякую.
То скажіть нам, що ви поробляєте, так як ми розуміємо тут, ви почали і продовжуєте вашу працю, ніби радієву і звучну, тим часом розуміємо, що це так званий модерний подкаст.
Yeah, well, you understand, you keep modernity, all the podcast, it's basically a radio program, but it's not on a radio station. It's available on an app on your cell phone. You can download it or you can get it on a computer. Like, for example, for my show, you can go to www.iheart.com and you look up the category and then you'll find the program and you can listen to it. So you can listen to the show that we released on Thursday, which is with a broadcaster and author named Terry O'Reilly, or you can listen to the 7 previous shows that we've already recorded. One we did with Peter Mansbridge, one with Lloyd Robertson, another one with Chef Massimo Capra, and a few comedians as well. So you can listen to all these programs that have been recorded in the past, and we'll be able to do that in perpetuity. So you don't have to be listening at any particular time because none of the shows are done live. They're all pre-recorded.
Okay. Well, that's interesting, but like, what is there an official website for your?
No, as I said, you can go to Spotify, you can go to Apple Podcasts, and you can find the program there. It's called Ted Vološin Podcast.
Okay, and so Ted, how do you як ви вишукуєте ваших так би мовити гостей, з якими ви говорите?
Well, near theme, it's not really theme driven. It's driven by personalities and individuals. In some cases, because they've written a book. Peter Mansbridge just wrote a book. Lloyd Robertson wrote a book. Comedian Ron James wrote a memoir. So we've interviewed them to talk about their books. Other people, we just talk about their careers, how they got their start in their career, what motivated them to get into that line of work, the kinds of successes that they've had, the kinds of hurdles that they've had to overcome. And it's quite fascinating. I mean, Peter Mansbridge got into television really by fluke. He was approached at an airport in Churchill, Manitoba. They were looking for somebody to announce flight arrivals. And somebody from somebody there said, well, would you be interested? And he applied, and yeah, he got the job, even though he wasn't qualified for it, but they didn't really care. And while he was doing the announcements for the flight arrivals, all of one terminal in Churchill, Manitoba, he was approached by somebody from CBC Radio who said, you've got quite a good voice. Have you ever thought about working in radio? And he said, never. He said, well, we have an opening for a late night position in our radio CBC affiliate in Churchill. Would you be interested? And he said, sure. And that's how he began his career and ended up as the host of the National for 30 years.
Well, so that means somebody found you at our Veselka Osella and got you on radio too, right?
And no, not really. But if you want, we can go with that story. Sure, why not?
So, Ted, how about personal life? I understand you went through COVID.
Yes, I had COVID.
And like, is it okay for us to talk about that?
Sure.
Do you know how you got it?
I got it through a friend who got it through another friend who didn't know that he had it. And that was before the vaccines were available. I was being as careful as I could, but I mean, people were getting it without knowing that they got it. And that's what happened. And I got it. And I was okay for the first few days or so, and then I started feeling I had difficulty breathing late one evening, and I called an ambulance. I went into the hospital, and I spent 10 days in the COVID ward, which is a room. It's a ward. It's a room that's built for two patients, but they only put one person in at a time. So I spent 10 days there. It wasn't intensive care, and I wasn't intubated, but I was on oxygen for 9 of those 10 days until they finally let me off oxygen, got me, weaned me off oxygen, and then I left a day later. But if anybody tells you it's like having the flu, you can tell them to go somewhere where the sun doesn't shine, because it's not like the flu. It's like having the flu and getting hit by a truck at the same time.
Okay, so how is it awful? Is it just being there? Does it hurt? Like, what do you have to go through?
It's extremely draining. It's exhausting. It's painful. I mean, it's the same when you have the flu. You know, you have muscle pain and you can't eat properly. Your digestive system is thrown out of whack. I don't want to get too graphic. In some cases, you know, you run a fever. There's difficulty breathing, depending on how badly you have it, right? And so, some people they get it and they just have mild symptoms and they manage to fend it off by staying home for a couple of weeks or a month or whatever it may be. And in other cases, it becomes quite serious. And some people, I had a friend, unfortunately, who died after he was exposed to COVID. So it's a very serious thing. So for people who are still sitting on the fence deciding whether to get vaccinated or not, I would strongly suggest that you do so. And if you don't want to do it for yourself, do it for everybody else around you, because you could inadvertently kill somebody.
You know, I do understand that we, you know, some of us are careful, wear the masks, you know, watch what we're doing. But I even those people that are careful, I don't know to what extent we understand that we're contributing to the common good by being careful. And it's almost like not necessarily just about me, but it's about everybody that I conceivably come in contact with.
Well, some people are more susceptible. They're immunocompromised. Those are the people who can't afford to get it. Those are the people that it could kill. Other people, as I mentioned, it bounces off them. But it's the responsibility of the people, of everybody, to make sure that they don't get it and then inadvertently give it to somebody else. You may think that you're built like a rock and you're 30 years old and you've never been sick a day in your life, but that doesn't mean that you won't get it necessarily. And if you get it, you could go visit Did or Baba and give it to them, and that'll kill them. And if you want to have that on your hands, then that's your choice. But for those people who feel that it's some sort of a scam, that somehow, well, first of all, people tell me, well, the government's making money from this. The government is not that well organized. They couldn't organize a 3-car funeral, never mind scamming people out of money with some vaccination. So those are just foolish assertions on people's parts. And follow the science, period.
Well, As usual, when you speak, you wind up either laughing or being speechless. So that's where I am right now. Like, I would like to, how do I say, thank you for your personal comments here right now. And я думаю, що ті з ваші зауваги є переносні і важливі для кожного з нас. And you know, hopefully maybe we switching back to the concept of your podcasts. I gather the importance of that is that you're always you when you're questioning, when you're involving other people, and you're bringing everybody back down to a sort of personal reality.
Well, they're not really interviews. People say, well, who do you, is it a series of interviews? And it's really more a series of conversations. I ask questions, as you would in an interview, but you ask questions when you have a conversation with people as well. And we end up in many cases talking about not just what necessarily they've written about in their book or their movie that they're about to release, but we start talking about other things in their lives, their grandchildren, their children, their interest in sports. We start talking about how frustrating the Toronto Maple Leafs are. We start talking about how exciting it was to watch the Blue Jays until they couldn't play anymore. So we talk about many different types of things. We talk about COVID. We talk about what's going on in the world, raising children, their experiences in life, what it's like living in Canada. I mean, Lloyd Robertson and Peter Mansbridge and Ron James, the comedian. I mean, they've traveled quite extensively across the country, and their observations of this disparate nation of ours are quite fascinating.
Okay, well, Ted, дякую дуже. Thank you very much for being with us. We wish you all the best with your podcast and success with that. And we congratulate you on not just coming through with COVID, but also thanking you for sharing your experience and your insight and conceivably your wisdom on that topic. So thank you very, very much.
Well, thanks for your interest, Yudi. I appreciate your support. Tamasha.